got it. Welcome back. It's all about Turkey Day.
Turkey.
Do you know how many turkeys are eaten on Thanksgiving in the United States?
Six.
Six turkeys in your house?
No, but I do like cooking turkeys. How many turkeys?
45 million turkeys.
Yeah, 45
on
million
Thanksgiving.
Turkeys?
Yes.
I wouldn't even think we have a turkey over there. Yeah. I thought he was a seal.
Oh, he was
that
last
was
week. He's doing all of his
previous
animal impressions.
Show.
45 million turkeys, so there's something going on
That's
there.
A lot of
people,
feathers.
It's a lot of feathers. It's a lot
how many of them are actually well done? I mean, like prepared well. Like,
well,
you know, are they dry and tough?
Not
and
the one I eat.
Not the one I cook. I like
definitely
to cook.
Not. I shouldn't say that. My sister-in-law makes turkey every year, and it's very good, Laurie. It's very good, delicious. Don't make it again. But anyway, so people have, they're investing in these turkeys, mm-hmm. and they've got their family, and I think a lot of people, maybe it's hit or miss with how they prepare those turkeys.
Really?
And so there's this site that I was telling you about. It's really awesome.
Here comes my New York accent.
It's really awesome, and there's just so much going on here. It's like butter.
Ball.
It's called butterball.com.
Yeah.
And it's got some wonderful help areas. It's got some videos. It's got frequently asked questions. Let me show you. Let me start by asking.
When you think of turkey, isn't that the only name that really comes to mind?
That's what I think of. Yeah,
yeah,
absolutely. Butterball. And I think, it used to be that they put butter under the skin.
Really?
And that's what made it so good. Yeah.
Hmm.
But I think, I'm maybe speaking out of line, but I don't think they do that anymore.
Now
that would be good.
Never mind.
They've been bred to generate their own butter under the skin.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
So let me start, Lee, by asking you, are you cooking Thanksgiving this year?
Yes, I am.
Okay, how many adults are you having?
3.5.
I'm not sure it takes a decimal. It read it as 35. So let's round up.
Okay,
four adults, how many kids?
Well, they're all kids if they're younger than me, but no kids.
No kids. Okay, so zero. So this perfect portions area allows you to figure out how large a turkey you need. Just put in how many adults and how many kids, and you need an 8-pound turkey.
Does that include whether or not you need leftovers?
Well, that's what I was just going to say. You can also indicate that you want leftovers. If you don't, it goes down to 6 pounds.
Mm.
And if you are big eaters, you can also indicate. So let's say you don't want leftovers, you're not big eaters, and so we're light
turkey?
Eaters is automatic. So a 2-pound turkey
that's
will
be... That's a chicken. I get 20-pound turkeys.
Well, and what's your favorite part of the chicken or the turkey?
The turkey, my favorite part, probably the breast meat.
Really?
But
I'm a butt person.
I will carve that thing up. Every bit of it gets used. I even like making turkey soup.
That's good.
Never mind.
Well, there's some good meat there.
The dark meat is usually sweeter.
That's right, and moister.
Yeah, especially because of the way it's baked. Or roasted.
Anyway, let's say you're having 16 adults over.
Whoa,
and
big party. Is this at your house?
8 children, and we're big eaters, and we want leftovers. You need a 40-pound
turkey. They make
turkey.
Them?
I guess so. Well, I suppose you can also...
Do two.
Do a couple.
Wow.
So anyway, that's kind of nice to figure it out, because I always have trouble with how much do we really need.
Very good right there.
Another thing that they have here is, it sort of looks like a little book here. You can click on Celebrate Together, and there's all these things here that you can do, different occasions, holidays.
Nice.
So you've got some ideas here for bagging or tenting your turkey.
I use the bag. I like the
do
bag
you do that?
A lot. It always comes out super tender.
Oh, I'll have to try that. I haven't usually, actually I don't cover it at all because I like the crispy skin.
Well, I like that
too.
So what you do with the bag is you cut it right before, like about 15 minutes before, and you pull it apart, and then you get the crispy.
You're a good cook, though. You
I
make
love
the best chili, I know. Anyway, then there's expert advice, and so you've got lots of information here, and you can even call the Turkey Talk Line, and you get to speak to somebody. You can ask your question.
Okay.
You can just shoot around some ideas, and there's always somebody on there from 8 a.m. to 8 p.m.
Wow.
That's Central Time, weekdays. Okay,
I know
so Monday
people
through
that
Friday.
Need to make that phone call.
Yeah, absolutely. I've never done it, but I would not be
not
afraid.
Lori.
I would not be afraid to do that. Another thing, you've got some information about food safety and healthy eating. Okay, so lots of do's and don'ts, and then some PDFs that you can download with conversions and timing checklists and a glossary and all that. I'm going to go over
to
you.
They have some recipe ideas there. Do they have you know, side dishes and things? Because I'm always looking for something new and exciting.
They do. They've got ideas for all kinds of things that you can add with your to add to your turkey. There's a holiday guide also, and then there's also the whoops, I just lost that. Hello, here we go. There's also videos, and I really like these because the video is only this one's a minute long, a minute and a half, but it's really good because it gives you step-by-step instructions on, for example, carving a turkey. I didn't know. Do we have sound on this? I didn't even know that.
When you're carving a turkey, you can do it on a platter or a cutting board.
Now, so who knew that you actually had to slice into the turkey before you make slices?
Place a folded paper towel under the turkey.
Everybody knows that.
This will keep the turkey from sliding as you carve. And now we're ready to carve. Start by making
a cut through the band of skin. Okay. So what she does anyway is she explains how to take how to take apart the turkey and also how to get really good slices out of the breast. And you know, I was watching this and I was like, wow, I never knew that because my breast slices are always kind of cut up and
it takes a lot of practice. And unfortunately, a lot of people only practice this once a year.
Right.
But one of the key things that people forget to do is when you take the turkey out, before you carve it, it has to cool for 15 or 20 minutes.
To keep all the juices inside.
Well, not just
right?
to keep the juices in, but it's too hot and too wiggly. Mm-hmm. So you let it
cool
a little bit, and it carves a lot better.
That's true. Well, there's also other products, and you can go, for example, to Tenderloins or Burgers and Franks and get some recipes. But some of the other things, for example, there's a mobile site. So you can actually download the iPhone or the mobile version, and you have the different calculators. You have also some PDFs that you can use. Butterball on the phone. So there's all these different mobile tools.
Do you think this will motivate Greg to get a kitchen set in here so we can do like a cooking show?
That'd be great.
There are people that want him to do that.
Really?
Yes.
That'd be awesome.
And when you call, they go, my name is Gibbons, may I help you please?
Everybody wants to get into the act.
Yes.
So one of the other things that I really loved that I found out last night was that Butterball is on Twitter.
On Twitter.
So you can click to follow Butterball on Twitter. Remember, we've talked about Twitter before. Twitter's a free microblogging
platform. And you're
on
it all the time.
And I'm on it all the time. But, I follow sites like Butterball, like Adobe, and, you know, BrainPop. And you get some great information from people who are tweeting on behalf of the company. So there's really some very good...
What I like is you see questions that other people ask. It's like, oh, that's a good question.
Yeah, and it's like direct access to these companies. So it's amazing. If you try to call customer service for a company, you can just go into that endless, black hole. But if you even tweet about a certain product, it's almost like within minutes that you get some kind of response on Twitter. Another thing is they have all these calculators, which are really... helpful. So let me see where I can get to those calculators. Here we go. Tips and how to, and then there's the, here we go. All the calculators and conversions. So
those are important.
You can type in how long to thaw. You want to know how long to thaw, say, a 12-pound turkey. It's 3 days in the refrigerator or 6 hours in cold water.
Okay. I usually do the water.
Yeah. We already looked at this one. How many portions do I need? How long to cook something. So that's always a hit or miss thing
great.
Also. So there's a lot you can do here with butterball.com, and you can have your Thanksgiving dinner, and everybody will say, ooh, it's like butter. We'll be back with more on Pompey's Cafe.
Got it.
It's like butter.